How should you insulate a walk-in cooler with foam insulation? Let's talk about it. So we seem to get this question a lot, and it's usually for a business such as a bar, a restaurant, or something like that, or if someone is turning their basement into a den and they're actually building out some sort of a walk-in cooler. But really what depends is what the structure's looking like as far as how to insulate it. What I mean is, if you're in the middle of a renovation and the structures are torn open and exposed, well, most likely spray foam is going to be the best bet for that situation. Or if you have a new build, either commercial building or residential, again, spray foam is probably going to be your best bet. If you're thinking open cell or closed cell, which one's best, it depends if it's going to be exposed. What we get a lot of times, if you have a walk-in cooler that is being renovated in some way where the cooler's already in place and maybe you just bought a restaurant or a bar or something and you're looking to renovate it, if you're gonna leave the foam exposed, we almost always recommend closed cell because of its durability. Keep in mind there's coating requirements as far as putting coatings on the foam itself. Make sure you're talking to your coat officials for that. If you're gonna leave it exposed, almost always closed cell. If you're looking at an enclosed structure around this walk-in cooler, just like an exterior wall or something, wall assembly, ceiling assembly, all that's already there, and you're looking to retrofit or you're looking to improve the space. Well, this is where something like injection foam could really come into play and solve this problem without you having to tear everything open. That's what injection foam is designed for, is to be injected into enclosed spaces. So if you have your wall assemblies already enclosed around this cooler and you want to avoid having to tear everything open, you should definitely consider injection foam for that application. Like I said, it really depends on what your cooler is set up like as far as accessibility. But if you have a cooler that's already enclosed and you want to make sure it's completely optimized, go to our link below to our Find a Dealer page where you can find your local RetroFoam dealer and you can make sure that cooler is as efficient as possible. This is the Professor Foam reminding you that building is a science.